Hello friends, in my this video, I am going to discuss about fast Fourier transformation MATLAB code. Okay, so fast Fourier transformation is basically one algorithm to compute the discrete Fourier transformation quickly. You all know from your theory classes. So what is the formula of discrete Fourier transformation? Just a quick recap. X of k equal to summation over small n equal to 0 to capital N minus 1 x of n e to the power minus of j 2 pi by capital N into k into small n, where small n varies from 0 to capital N minus 1 and where k is also varies from 0 to capital N minus 1, where n is the n point DFT which we have to compute. Suppose, and this n is sometimes already, sometimes it is given in the question itself. Suppose it is asked that you have to compute 4 point DFT, then capital N equal to 4. Suppose it is asked that you have to compute 8 point DFT, then you have to put capital N equal to 8. In this way, we do. But suppose sometime if it is not mentioned, the capital N value is not mentioned, then we determine the capital N value from the length of the discrete time sequence or discrete time signal X of N. Suppose X of N is of length 4, then obviously capital N will be 4. Suppose X of N is of length 8, then capital N will be obviously of length 8. Suppose X of N is of length 6, then what to do? We know 4 point and 8 point. So obviously we have to convert this 6 point, the X of N which is of length 6, we have to convert it into a sequence of length 8 by padding two zeros at the end, and then we will compute 8 point DFT. That means if X of N is of length 6 also, then also you have to put capital N value as 8, right? These things you know from your basic concepts. Now, how to write the MATLAB code to compute fast Fourier transformation? See, first line, you write CLC, clear all, close all, these things no need to explain, right? Then you write the sequence X of N. Then you write in the next line, you write the n point DFT. That means suppose it is capital N equal to 8, which, what is the DFT you want to perform? Either it is 8 point, 4 point, that thing you have to write in the parameter capital N, which is obviously dependent on small x of n, right? And one more thing, this is the most important line to perform the fast Fourier transformation in MATLAB. X of k equal to FFT. Carefully notice, all the three are in small letter. Small f, small t, right? So X of k is equal to FFT of X of n. So first the sequence, comma, capital N. Suppose it is 4 point FFT, then X of n, comma, 4 also you can directly write. So this is the basic program. And one more thing, just I will give a quick recap. See, X of k, from this expression only, we can say that X of k is basically will come out as a complex sequence, right? So we can plot the magnitude and phase spectrum, magnitude and phase component of this complex sequence. What is the code to plot the magnitude and complex part? Yes, I have already explained these things in my previous video, where I have discussed how to plot the complex exponential signal in MATLAB. Anyway, I will just give the idea here also. To plot the complex sequence, that is to plot the magnitude part and the phase part separately, we have to use these two commands. That is, to get the magnitude part, we have to use abs x of n, and to get the phase part, we have to use angle x n. Suppose we want to plot the magnitude part of x of n here is basically a complex sequence, then how we write? Stem n comma abs x of n, okay? And obviously, carefully notice, we use stem. Why? Because whenever we want to plot the discrete time sequence, we use stem. Whenever we want to plot the continuous time sequence, we write plot command, right? These things you know. So stem n comma abs x of n to plot the magnitude part of the complex sequence X of n, and to plot the phase part, we have to write stem n comma angle X of n. These things you know. Similarly, here suppose I want to plot the magnitude and phase part of x of a, that is DFT of x of n. If we want to plot the magnitude and phase part, how we have to write? Yes, how? Stem n, comma, here n is what? N is not, here n will not be written, we have to write k, because x of k is function of k instead of n, right? So it will be stem k comma abs x of k. To plot the magnitude part and to plot the phase part, we have to write stem k comma angle x of k, right? Obviously, I think it is now clear to you. Now just let us go to an example so that it will be more clear. See, write a MATLAB program. Write a MATLAB program to perform 4-point DFT of the discrete time signal or sequence, also you can say x of n equal to 1, 1, 2, 3, using the function FFT and sketch the magnitude and phase spectrum. Okay, so let us start. I will directly go to code. So first line is CLC to clear the command window. If your command window is already clear, then no need to write. Okay, so x of n equal to what is our sequence? 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, right? So 1, 1, 2, 3. In this way, you can write the sequence. Otherwise, you can, instead of giving space, you can give comma also. Then also you will get the same result. 1, 1, 2, 3, right? Now, what point DFT we have to perform? Obviously, 4 points. So n equal to 4. Now, x of k equal to, what is the code? FFT, all in small, carefully notice, x of n comma capital N. Okay, now just let us see what is happening. Copy the code from editor window, paste it in command window, click enter, and see, we get the DFT of the sequence x of n 1 1 2 3, that is this one, 7 plus 0i minus 1 plus 2i, minus 1 plus 0i, minus 1 minus 2i. And see here, you can also get an idea that this result is correct, because we can use that property, that is x of k is equal to x star of n minus k. See here, suppose we take this element, that is, this is x of 3 for k equal to 3, right? This is k equal to 0, k equal to 1, k equal to 2, and k equal to 3. So x of 3 should be equal to x star of n minus 3, here n is 4, so x star of 1, so x of 3 will be equal to x star of 1. See, x of 3 is minus 1 minus 2i, and x of 1 is minus 1 plus 2i, so x star of 1 is minus 1 minus 2i, that is equal to x of 3. So x of 3 equal to x star of 1, that also, that property also holds. So in this way, in examination, in theoretical exam also, you can check your answer. Okay, that is x of k is equal to x star of n minus k, very useful property. Now, what do you want? We want to plot this magnitude and phase part, because see, in the question itself, it is mentioned that also sketch the magnitude and phase spectrum. Okay, so let us plot that. So to plot that, first we have to define the range of k. So k equal to 0 to 3, 0 to n minus 1, here n is equal to 4, so n minus 1 equal to 3. So k equal to 0 to 3. Now stem k comma, first we will plot the absolute part or the magnitude part, abs x of k. Now let us check. See here. See, this is the magnitude part, magnitude plot, that is at 0 it is 7, at k equal to 1 it is here, at k equal to 2, this is the magnitude, and at k equal to 3, here is the point. Okay, so this is the what? This is the magnitude plot of the sequence, DFT of the sequence x of n. Now, suppose we want to plot the angle part, stem stem k comma angle, to plot the phase part, we have to write angle x of k, right? See what we can get. See, this is the phase plot. At k equal to 0, it is 0. At k equal to 1, it is here. At k equal to 2, it is here. And at k is equal to 3, it is coming to negative side and it is here. Okay. So this is how we can plot the magnitude and phase part of the DFT of a sequence. And one more thing, that's what I have written here. I will just show you the code. So basically this code is this CLC, then x of n equal to 1, 1, 2, 3. Instead of giving space, you can give comma. Then also it is fine. Then capital N equal to 4 because we want to compute 4-point DFT. Then x of k is equal to FFT of x of n comma n. To plot the magnitude and phase spectrum, what we have to do? As x of k is a complex sequence, so it will have magnitude and phase part. So as capital N is equal to 4, so that small n will vary from 0 to capital N minus 1, that is 0 to 3. And same for k, that also k is equal to from 0 to 3. Now to plot the magnitude spectrum, I have to write this code, that is stem k comma abs x of k. Why I am not writing plot? Because we want to plot the magnitude spectrum in, obviously in discrete domain, it is not in continuous domain. Then how we can use plot? Because plot will give us the continuous time domain, right? So we have to use stem. This is the code to write the magnitude spectrum and to plot the phase spectrum, stem k comma angle x of k. Okay, so this is how you have to solve the numericals. You can cross check with your theoretical procedure. You can solve this and cross check that is it giving same result with MATLAB. So this is all for my this video. I will post the same code in the description of my this video so that you can easily copy and check in your laptop in MATLAB software. Okay, thank you for watching. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section.